Today we'll start with biology class. So human health and diseases yet to complete, no? 90% of the portions from health and human health and diseases that we have completed, isn't it? All the diseases we have studied, about the immune system we have studied. And the last two topics, very very simple topics, the topics left out are the alkaloids, the plant alkaloids. The alkaloids obtained from the plants, the topic that we are going to see today. And the next one is adolescence, characteristics of adolescence, and the addiction, the drug addiction. About the drug addiction, we have to study alcohol addiction, drug addiction, we have to study. So these are the two topics yet to complete. And today we will start with the alkaloids. What are these alkaloids? The alkaloids are the chemical substances or the natural substances which is being extracted from the bark of a plant. Which has been extracted from the bark of the plant. Either it can be extracted from the dried flower or otherwise from the leaves, or otherwise it can be in the form of an exudate. What is meant by exudate? Exudate is a resinous substance that is being extracted out from the plant. Naturally, the plant will gives away those exudates or otherwise the resins from the bark of the stem or otherwise on the twig region or where the nodes and the nodal regions are present, there the exudates will be present, isn't it? The exudates will come out in the form of a latex or otherwise in the form of a resin. So the alkaloids can be extracted from a flower, the floral parts of it we can extract, or otherwise from the root region or otherwise from the bark region or otherwise on the leaves, and sometimes from the seeds and the fruits also, and even the exudates. Even the exudates like a resinous exudate or otherwise a latex exudate can also be taken as an alkaloids. Can you understand? So, in our textbook, in our NCERT book, we have given three alkaloids as a type study. The first alkaloids is called as opioids. The first alkaloid which we are going to see is opioids, isn't it? Opioids drug, we are taking alkaloid. This opioid is obtained from a plant. The plant is called as Pepover somniferum. Pepover somniferum. Pepover is a family. Okay, from opioids. This opioids can otherwise be called as a smack. It can otherwise be called as what? It can otherwise be called as smack. We will study about the opioids. The second one which we are going to study is cannabinoids. What we are going to study is the alkaloid is cannabinoids, which is obtained from the alkaloid which is obtained from cannabis sativus. Cannabis sativus. The alkaloid is called as cannabinoids. Then the last one, opioids, cannabinoids. Next one is cocaine. The last alkaloid is called as what? The last alkaloid which we are going to study is cocaine. The alkaloid is cocaine, which is obtained from a plant. This is here, cocaine, which is obtained from the plant, that is Erythroxylum coca. And similarly, atrophin also have the similar characteristic features of cocaine. So this atrophin comes under a category of cocaine. And this is also being extracted from Atropha belladonna, obtained from the plant, that is Atropha and even drugs can also be obtained from the Datura species, can also be obtained from the Datura species. So, Datura species is being obtained. So, Atropha belladonna. So, what are the three alkaloids which we are going to study? Three alkaloids which we are going to study is opioids, cannabinoids, and the last one is called as cocaine. So, what are the three alkaloids? One is opioids, cannabinoids, the other one is called as what? Cocaine. What is this opioid? Opioids is obtained from Papaver somniferum. The plant, how we have to pronounce, have to keep it in mind. That is Papaver somniferum. Cannabinoid acetate, which is obtained from Cannabis sativus. The plant is called as Cannabis sativus. And cocaine, which is Erythroxylum coca. Okay, now we will start atrophin. Atrophin is also a derivative of this cocaine, and this atrophin is being extracted from Atropha belladonna. The plant species is called as one Atropha belladonna. So we are getting what? Atrophin. Atrophin is an alkaloid, which is a derivative of this cocaine. Okay, now we will start with opioids. Okay, so it is opioids, it is a kind of a drug obtained from opium poppy, common name, that I am learning, opium poppy. Opium poppy is nothing but what? Papaver somniferum. Papaver somniferum, and even the drugs plus their derivatives together is called as opioids. What is this opioids? Opioids is nothing but it is a drug which is directly obtained from a plant which is called as what? Papaver somniferum, and along with their derivatives, they are called as what? Opioids. This opioid, so the characteristic feature, the main unique feature of opioids is this opioids finds its attachment to the specific receptor sites which are present in the central nervous system and gastrointestinal tract. Okay, so what I have written is saying, see this opioids, the name, the foremost characteristic features of this opioids is, this opioids finds its attachment to the specific receptor sites which is present in the central nervous system and the gastrointestinal tract. So it affects the central nervous system and what? And the gastrointestinal tract. Opioids finds its attachment to the specific receptor sites which is present in the central nervous system and gastrointestinal tract. Okay. So this opioids will take, they are chemically, this opioids are chemically diacetyl derivative, diacetyl morphine. Chemically they are what? Diacetyl morphine, and they are color, they are white in color, and they are odorless. They are what? They are odorless, and similarly they are bitter in taste, which is obtained from Papaver somniferum. Chemically they are diacetyl morphine, which is white in color and it is odorless. O-D-O-U-R, odorless, and it is bitter in taste. So what is the first point? The drug, this opioids is a drug which is obtained from opium poppy, which is called as Papaver somniferum, and the derivatives together is called as opioids. This opioids finds its attachment to the specific receptor sites which is present on the central nervous system, and the GIT is gastrointestinal tract. And chemically, when you take this opium, they are diacetyl morphine. They are the derivatives of the diacetyl morphine, and similarly, it is white, odorless, and then it is bitter in taste. Okay, so how it is being taken, we will see. How it is the route, how it is being taken. So it is being taken, this opioids are usually taken by eating or through smoking. sometimes through snorting. It is through the snorting. And the root we have written. What is its impact? Physiological effect. This physiological effect is, it is actually sedated. It is actually a sedated. And sometimes it is used as an analgesic. What is analgesic? Analgesics means painkiller. Sedative means it's a kind of a tranquilizer drug that we have studied in chemistry. Isn't it? Chemistry in everyday life we would have studied about opium. I only thought. Isn't it? So sedative, and then it is analgesics. Then it slows down. It slows down the body function. And it leads to the glandular under secretion, slows down the process. Digestion slows down the process of what? Slows down the process of the digestion. Okay, leads to glandular under secretion and it slows down the process of digestion. So, what is the physiological effect? It is sedative, analgesic, slows down the body function. Adverse effects. Adverse effect. Increased utilization. Something is now decreased. Energy, interest in work and weight, body weight. Okay, then decreased energy, interest, and then we are calling this body weight. What are the different types of opioids we have? That is, natural opioids we have, synthetic and semi-synthetic. The natural opioids we will see now. The natural opioids are morphine and sedaine. Morphine and sedaine. Okay, then semi-synthetic opium. So semi-synthetic opioids are heroin. Okay, the last one is synthetic opioids are methadone, Petidine, and one more is there, the structure that we have to draw for this morpheme that they have given in the textbook. Okay, then the structure for morpheme let me draw for you. The chemical structure they have given is an organic structure. So it is an organic compound, C17H19O3N. This is nothing but morpheme. How to draw the structure is basically by seeing this formula, we can identify C17 means compulsively it will be having a benzene ring. Whenever the benzene ring is present, isn't it C6? Benzene C6 mela pona. So obviously C17 is there. So compulsively it should be a, we should have a benzene ring. Whenever benzene ring is present, then it should be an unsaturated hydrocarbon. So made up of double bond, unsaturated. And coming to nitrogen, only one N is present. One N, if it is going to present, that shows it is tertiary amine. Chemistry of tertiary amine. Amino derivatives there. 12th chapter you have primary, secondary, tertiary, and quaternary amines. Quaternary salts are very important. It's a tertiary amine. When tertiary amine or nitrogen is present, that shows it will be having one CH3 group. One CH3 group it should have. Alkyl group should be there because tertiary amine cannot exist as such like N form. So it will be having one CH3 group. Then oxygen. How about the oxygen? What this oxygen symbolizes? This O is 3, isn't it? So how many O is present? 3 O's. The first two and the second O will be representing the alcohol. Upper one OH will represent phenol. The another OH will represents aliphatic alcohol. And one more oxygen is present, that oxygen will be ether derivative. Will be what? Will be ether. So this is how the structure should be. Now let me draw the structure for you. This is for the morpheme. This is for what? This is for the morpheme. Let me draw first. So phenol have drawn. Then here also one OH derivative, and here it will be OH. The other one is H. Okay, here again unsaturation, again you should have unsaturation. And apart from that, this is nothing but they call it as a morpheme. So I told you 3 O's, 1, 2, 3 O's of present alcohol. The aliphatic are not there, then this is nothing but ether constituency, tertiary amines of the methyl group, then aromatic ring structure is present, and this is the structure which they have given in the textbook for the morpheme. Okay, now, so today what we are studying about? Today we are studying about the alkaloids. Alkaloids, so we have 3 alkaloids. So what are those 3 alkaloids we have? So we have 3 alkaloids. What are the 3? What are those 3 alkaloids? One is opioids. Second one is cannabinoidus, third one is cocaine. Opioids can otherwise be called as a snack, which is obtained from the plant. That is pepover somniferum. So opioids, when you take, it is a kind of a drug which is obtained from opium poppy, and also their derivatives together we are calling it as what? We are calling it as opioids, isn't it? The opioids usually finds its attachment towards the receptor site, which is present on the central nervous system and gastrointestinal tract. Since it is finding its attachment towards the receptor site on the central nervous system, obviously it affects the central nervous system. So that is why it is used as a sedative. Sedative is a tranquilizer. It's a kind of a tranquilizer drug. So it is a sedative. And then it is an analgesic. What is an analgesic? It release from the pain. So that is what we are calling as a pain killer, and slows down the body function. Body's metabolism, body functions will be getting deteriorated. And similarly, it leads to the glandular under secretion, the hormonal imbalances, the secretions, even for the digestion, certain enzymes, for the hormones, for the normal body metabolism to be maintained, everything will be getting altered. And similarly, slows down the process of digestion. What happens when it is being rotated in excess? The adverse impact will be created. At an adverse condition, it leads to decreased energy, interest, and sometimes it leads to the fatigue condition also. These natural opioids, some examples are given, it is morphine, sedaine. Semi-synthetic is heroin. Synthetic is methadone. The other one is called as pepidin. So now, the structure I have given for morphine, which they have given you in the NCERT book. So just to know, I have drawn the structure. This is not very important for your examination. So based on the structure, what are all the clues that can be written? Unsaturation would add totally 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 unsaturations should be present here. Here totally 9 unsaturations are present. 9 unsaturations will be present. Okay. So this structure also I have given for you to understand. So opioids is over. Now we go to the next alkaloid. The next alkaloid is cocaine. We pass it on to the next alkaloid. It affects brain and even cardiovascular system parts, circulatory system, cardiovascular system, even it obstructs the cardiovascular system. So adverse condition, it affects, and it is actually opaque. So where it is opaque, you will see. It is actually obtained from the floor, or the top of the floor. Particularly in case of the influences. In the particular lab, in the type of floor we have from the female floor. From the female floor is obtained. Sometimes the leaves also can be used as an alkaloid extract, and similarly the resins also can be taken. Sometimes the resins can also be taken. So top of the floor, leaves and resins also can be taken. What are the various types of them? How are written there for opioids? Similarly here also. The first one is ganja. Second one is hashish. Third one is heras. Third one is what? So first one is ganja, second one is hashish, third one is heras, and very important form is it. This is third one, isn't it? The very important one is marijuana. Marijuana. These are the various types of cannabinoids. Hashish, ganja. Morphine, sedaine, heroin, methadone, the other one is called as what? Pepidin. These are types of water, opioids. And similarly, for cannabinoids, we have ganja, hashish, cannabis, the other one is called as marijuana. So these are the various types or various forms. How it can be taken, we will see. So, route, entry, through injection. And sometimes it can be taken orally also. It can be taken what? It can be taken orally. And similarly, it can be taken through smoking. Can you understand? Now we will start with the first one. We will start with marijuana. We will start with this marijuana. See, this marijuana or nothing but marijuana, we can see it in the dried flowers, leaves, dried flowers and leaves. The flowers of the acrobium, the female. And this marijuana leads to psychosis. Leads to psychosis. What is psychosis? Loss of contact with external world. So, loss of contact with the external world. The external world. This part is what? Psychosis. So it causes psychosis. The next one what we have is ganja. So then the other one is hashish, we will see. The other one what we have is what? Ganja. The other one is ganja. When you take out this ganja, it is obtained from the unfertilized female inflorescence. Unfertilized female inflorescence where the arrangement of petals are present. Where the petals should be present. Arrangement of petals should be there. Arrangement of petals. The next one is hashish. When you take out this hashish varieties, hashish, this hashish is obtained from dried resin. Obtained from there? From the dried resin. Okay, so we have marijuana, we have ganja, and we have hashish. So these are the various forms or various types of cannabinoids. Understood. So cannabinoids shall be twice once again. So what is that cannabinoids? It is obtained from cannabis sativa, which is called as a hemp plant. Adverse condition, it affects the brain and the cardiovascular system. It is obtained from the top of a flower, that is inflorescence, leaves and resins, which is a female flower. Various types, when you take the various types, will be ganja, hashish, cannabis and marijuana. The root today can be taken through the injection or otherwise through orally or sometimes by smoking or inhaling also. Then when you take this marijuana, the dried flowers and leaves are called as a marijuana. It leads to psychosis. What is meant by psychosis? Loss of contact with the external world. The other one is ganja. There is an unfertilized female inflorescence which is dried and powdered to be used as dried form. Everything should be dried. So the dried form, isn't it? Will be used as ganja. The hashish is the dried resin, will be used as the hashish. Okay. So this is about what? This is about the cannabinoids. The last, only one more alkaloid is there. Last alkaloid will be cocaine. The last alkaloid is, I hope in a simplified way I have given, point by point I have written on the book. That is, in the book it has given in a paragraph form. It's very difficult to understand. So that is what I am doing in this way. So you have to study. Okay. The next one what we have is cocaine. The alkaloid is called as what? Cocaine. Okay.
When you take out this cocaine, it is obtained from erythroxylum coca. It is obtained from what? Erythroxylum coca. And it is a native of, this erythroxylum coca is native of South America. And it is an effective nervous stimulant. Effective nervous stimulant. It is an effective nervous stimulant. Can you take here? It induces impact under the effect of adverse effects. So it creates a condition of what? It creates a condition of native of South America, it is an effective nervous stimulant. It causes sense of well-being, excess energy, obstructing. And similarly, the drug will also be used as an allocene, can also be used as an allocene. So this is about the next topic. One is opions, the other one is what we have cannabinoids, the other one is cocaine. So everything I have written on the board, then you have to switch and you have to prepare well for the exam. The last topic is adolescence. That is very very simple. Generally that can be explained. Okay, so those things will be explained for you on the later classes. From next tomorrow or after tomorrow's classes. Okay, so sit and prepare for the examinations.